Hello. Yesterday I taught you how to build an API in the new Space Engineers programming API. Very basic stuff. Today we're going to do a little bit more advanced stuff. We're going to make a player that can starve to death. The thing to bring up at this moment is I'm using monodevelop, the Unity branch. That is not a recommendation. The reason that I'm using it is because I know that a lot of people who follow my channel use Unity and already have this IDE, and that it's got some bugs. So I wanted to set this up in a buggy IDE so nobody who had it would get lost or confused or annoyed. If you don't have the monodevelop that Unity comes with, there's no reason to go out of your way to get it. Any IDE will work. All we're doing is programming C sharp code. We're not even compiling it. So anything you can add references to will work. That said, let's get started. I created a new class just like before, and I added in a lot of our using directives just like before. And so now the option that we need is well, we got to attach this to something. What do we want to attach it to? Well, let's go ahead and attach it to the player because this is all about a player that starves to death, right? But attaching things to a player is fraught with difficulties and traps. There is, in fact, a My Object Builder player. It doesn't work. It doesn't do this. This is not the right way to attach to a player. It will not work if you try this. Instead, we have to attach it to a character. Down here, let's override the every 100 frames. Now, every 100 frames, this will run, and we're just going to go ahead and tell ourselves that we're running. Very straightforward. We've saved, and we'll just go into the Space Engineers and create a new world. Now, when I said that it was fraught with difficulties, I was not talking about simply not being named what you might think. We're going to hit OK, and we're going to wait for this to happen. By the way, there doesn't appear to be any way at this moment to access the health or energy of the player. I expect that that'll be coming. This mod is very, very young. All right, here we've loaded it up, but we're not seeing anything. There are no errors in our loading, so why aren't we seeing anything? Well, let's hit reload. F5 reloads. Doop, 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 doop. Running. 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 Okay, so there is a bug. I'm not sure if it's a bug or a misfeature, but there is a situation where the path that is used to create players is different depending on whether you're just creating the world or loading it. Not sure why that is, but basically these player-attached scripts at the moment, this is only the Sunday after the API was released, but at the moment they only work after you've loaded the game. With that in mind, let's create ourselves some food. And here we'll just subtract a large amount, just so that we can get ourselves going with the concept of dying of starvation. Obviously, that is not the speed at which you would normally die of starvation. Over in here, hit F5 to load it again. Sorry about the noises. Bonk. Food 90. Food 80. Food 70. Okay, so we've got a pretty good setup. Now we just need it to make the player die when he runs out of food. Okay, that's fairly straightforward. Not less than or equal to 10, less than or equal to 0. So how do we find the player? Well, we're attached to the player, but what we need to do is we need to create an IMY object. The object builders are the classes which create all of these objects, but the objects themselves are the IMY objects. However, there is no IMY character. So the My Object Builder underscore character does not create an IMY character. Or if it does, we don't have access to the IMY character class. It does have an IMY player, but the IMY player is not the same as what is created by the object builder that builds characters. There are a lot of ways to find the character that you are trying to use, But the basic idea is that we're going to use the IMI controllable entity. So we've just decided that this is our entity, and we've cast it accordingly. Now we can just go ahead and double check that. Like so. There's a little bit of waiting while the game loads, unfortunately. Food, 90, 80. We've got to wait for that to get down. I wasn't thinking about speed here, so there's a little bit of time before we can actually see the error. 20, 10, and now. See? Default astronaut. So that is our controllable entity. The controllable entity we're using is the default astronaut entity. And if we look at this, we have a lot of options. And one of our options, right at the top, is die. Hey, gravity generator, how you doing? Ooh, look. Medical rooms is not gonna help you. All your HP and NP were covered, but you still feel hungry. Didn't work. What didn't work? Why didn't it work? As far as I can tell, I'm sure that there is a debug log, but I actually can't find it. But as far as I can tell, the dying does not happen like you might think. As you can see, we did not die. And even though we're telling ourselves to die every frame, we don't appear to be actually doing it. So how can we cause ourselves to die? We've got a lot of other options. How about we make ourselves jump, just to make sure that we are, in fact, controlling everything properly. Let's change this to minus equals 40. So that we do it a little bit faster. Grind, 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 grind. Wah! 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 So, it's working, except that the die command doesn't work. I can only presume that that's a bug, and needs to be fixed in a later version of the API. Well, what else can we do? Obviously, jumping around when you get hungry is kind of funny, but it's not really what we would like to do. We actually have a couple of options for getting the more advanced stuff, but not via this path. We have to actually back out and go get the players manually, and get the actual player object. And that's a little bit annoying to try and do, and it doesn't really offer us any more advanced features over die. The fact that die doesn't work is a bug, and we can't really move forward until we fix it. We also can't manually reduce the health of the character based on their hunger, because we have no access to the hunger stat. If we look at the players, so if we look at the IMyPlayer object, we can, in fact, get these IMyPlayer objects, not in the way we're doing it, but in another way. If we look at our options here, you can see that we've got the player character as a subclass, which is what we're using. And here we've got a request respawn, which might be what we actually need to use. Maybe. It's hard to tell. And here we've got an entity controller and a player character. Ah. So here's a controllable entity, and here's an entity controller. So there are two things, see? So let's see what this has to say. Camera, player, take control. We could take control, I guess. Nope. Really, there's nothing better than dying. But let's go ahead and give it a shot here with our list I'm my player, players equals new. So if you don't have access to this list, that's because I've added in the system collections generic namespace, which is where it's hiding, so you can go ahead and fetch that if you need it. And now we can get a list of all of the players, like so. We say my API gateway dot entities dot, not entities, my bad, dot players dot get players, and then we pass it in that list, and it'll fill that list out for us. And then we can go for int a equals 0, a is less than players dot count a plus plus. If players a dot player character equals imsk, now we know the player. We've got the player that we're trying to use. So players a dot request respawn. Well, let's also go ahead and say something just so that we know that it's happening. By the way, not all objects come with the update after simulation 100 enabled. There are plenty of classes which do not have that enabled by default, and you can set those up using a flag system, but we're not going to go over that. You can look that up if you need it, or request it in the comments if you need it, but the player comes with that enabled by default, so. Oh. So, we can't die, but we can respawn. Here's something funny, though. How you doing, me? Looking good. So now what we've done is we've left our body behind. Well, what happens if we request respawn and then kill off our buddy? By the way, this die and respawn thing is actually, I'm working up to something with it, but it's going to be quite a while before it's ready. So we died, and we respawned, and oh, you're still alive, because die doesn't work. That's just all there is to it. Die does not work. I'm presuming that's a bug that'll be fixed soon. So what else can we do? Well, we can actually just tell the entire entity to get itself deleted. And we're gone. So there we are. Until die starts to work, that's how we're going to have to kill people off. And now we've created a mod where the player can starve to death. However, you'll notice that this player does not seem to be dying. And the reason for that is I'm not actually sure whether or not it's because I'm not actually sure why that is. I presume it's because the My Object Builder character is malfunctioning in the same way that the that it malfunctions when we first load the game. So, if we go back over into this and we save it, and then we load it, the food script should reattach. But as you can see, this is not ideal. So there are lots of bugs in this API, or misfeatures, I'm not sure which, that will need to be addressed. And, meh, we'll work it out in the long run. Blech. See, we're not dying or anything. We're not attached to this player object because it hasn't been created in the standard manner. So, yep, fun bugs. If you are watching this in October sometime, or later, chances are these bugs have been fixed. And the script will work fine for you, and you won't have to do any of this running around business with manually deleting entities. Well, anyhow, I hope you've learned a lot, or at least a little bit, and thank you for sticking with it.